great damage, but there is new help on the way for at least one group. Today, 53 children in need flew into Pittsburgh. This is the video of that moment. Pennsylvania Governor Ed Rendell and Congressman Jason Altmaier led the mission along with two sisters who ran the orphanage.
It was a really tough week living in a driveway with hundreds of children, but the fact that we're here now is certainly worth it. And just thank you to everyone. I'm so proud to bring these kids back to Pittsburgh.
These kids were unbelievable. After all they've been through in their lives and since the earthquake, the spirit and the good humor of these kids was just unbelievable.
Well, joining us now, Pennsylvania Congressman Jason Altmaier, who was on that plane. And Congressman, thank you for joining us. We know there's not a lot in this story to be happy about, but before I even saw your face, my producer said you had the biggest smile on your face, so proud to be a part. What was it like to be on that plane, especially when you touched down in Pittsburgh?
Well, Allie and Jamie, who ran that orphanage, were my constituents, and we've been working on getting them out of Haiti along with the children under their care for about a week now. So to finally have been able to go into the airport and personally see the look on the faces of them and the kids as we put them on the plane and flew them into Pittsburgh and brought them home, it was an amazing experience.
Looks from the video, a lot of the kids walked out under their own will. I know some were taken to the hospital for medical attention. Update us on that.
All the kids were taken to Children's Hospital in Pittsburgh for a medical checkup. It doesn't look like any of the children have life-threatening situations, but a lot of them are dehydrated. Some of them have respiratory issues and maybe a little bit worse than that, but I think everybody's going to be okay. And these are children, by and large, that were going to adoptive families in the United States, so we made a lot of parents happy, too. It's just a great outcome.
Now, it was just yesterday, I believe, that the U.S. immigration officials announced the emergency humanitarian program to expedite many of these adoptions on a case-by-case basis, but with these 53 kids, especially the ones you mentioned that were already in the process, what happens now?
Well, they are going to go to their adoptive parents at some point. They still have to go through the appropriate process.
Where will they be in the meantime?
Well, they're in Pittsburgh right now. A lot of them are in Children's Hospital still. That is going to be resolved. What we have done was take them out of harm's way. The situation we encountered was an orphanage run by a couple of young women presents a pretty inviting target for people who will do anything to get their hands on much-needed supplies. We had to get them out of the danger zone. We've brought Allie and Jamie home, and we're going to try to get these kids to their parents as quickly as possible.
And we're looking at pictures of the kids with crayons. It looked like one little girl was even kind of dancing there. And I don't want to push the timeline too much, but you have people who are obviously naturally curious to know how soon these kids might be with their new parents or their parents. I shouldn't say new parents, their parents. Right. What is the ideal timeline?
That is going to be determined by the immigration and adoption agencies. That's something that has yet to be determined. My concern was bringing my constituents, Allie and Jamie, home, making sure the kids were safe as they made the trip. We have done that, so today we're just taking a deep breath and we're going to move on from here.
I bet you are. And of the 53 children, do you have a number on how many of them have not actually been adopted?
Well, there's two groups. There are those who weren't far along in the adoption process. There were also several that had their records destroyed in the earthquake. So we're piecing that together. There are going to be a handful that aren't in the process for adoption, but almost all of them are going to go to American families.
And all 53 are safe right now, and that is the blessed part of this story.
That's right.
All right, Congressman Altmaier, thank you very much, and congratulations on the great work in getting them back here.